Alright, this tutorial 2.0 will be separated into two separate videos. The first will cover the first two parts of the tutorial, which is the sketch and the preparation, and the second video will cover the last two parts of the tutorial, which is the painting and cleanup and the finishing. So all four of those parts in those two videos are right here, and you can click on the annotation for whatever part of the video you want to go to, so that you don't have to scroll through the whole video and search for whatever you want to see. So do that, and I will see you wherever you decide to click. So the sketch stage here is fairly basic and really open-ended, and you can really sketch however you would like. All my sketches are really, really messy, as you can see, but for me it tends to not really matter so much because I don't plan on sharing my sketches or anything like that, and really the sole purpose of the sketch for me is to establish a general foundation of what I'm going to draw. So it's okay for it to be messy as far as I'm concerned. During the process, I move and transform a lot of parts of the drawing until things look more or less the way I want them to look in terms of basic composition and pose and that sort of thing. Usually I'll do sketches in some color. Here I'm using blue. I usually sketch in any other color than black for no particular reason other than it's just something left over from when I used to do line work, when I would do the sketches in color and then go over in black just to be able to distinguish between the two, but that's the story for another time. So anyway, once I'm satisfied with the sketch, I'll go into hue and saturation and change the sketch to a darker color. Sometimes I'll change it to black, but usually I'll just change it to a really dark color. In the end, I guess what's really important about this stage is just to have a fairly solid foundation. My sketches are super messy, but since I know what's gonna go where, essentially that's what really matters. So long as you can read your sketch and it helps set the stage for what you're going for, I'd say you're good. You're in the clear so long as you know what you're doing, you know? I don't really think it's all that necessary to make your sketch super clean unless that's what you want. And also, for what it's worth, a cleaner sketch does make cleaning up later in the process a lot easier. I find myself getting really frustrated with my messy sketches, like, later on in the drawing. I wish I would have been a bit neater in the beginning, but that's another story for another time. In the end, really, it's just a matter of how you prefer to do your own sketches, so whatever you're most comfortable with is what you should do. As far as anatomy and things go, it's important to practice. Don't stress out over perfection, but definitely do put in the effort to practice. And remember that your own body is a huge resource. If you can't picture how a pose should look, try and position yourself in that pose and see how it works out. I mean, see if it's possible. Do weird poses in the mirror. I'm totally advocating this with the warning that yes, it will be totally awkward if someone walks in on you doing this. Hands always give me a really hard time, and I always find myself using my own hands for reference. Take pictures of your hands and see how they look. Put your hands to more work than just drawing. I have a ton of really weird webcam pictures of just my hands that I took to see how hands work in different like poses and stuff. So remember that your body is a really huge, easily accessible resource for you, and you know, make use of it. Same, I guess, if you have friends or family that are willing to make weird poses and stuff for you, ask them about that, I mean, if you want to. But there's loads of different ways to practice. Just keep at it. Especially with drawing digitally, one thing that I do a lot, especially in the sketch stage, is to transform and like shrink different bits of the sketch when I kind of feel that they don't look anatomically correct. So that's always an option as well. You can always change how things look in your drawings if you don't think that they look right. It's also a good idea to flip your drawing occasionally to see if it looks good on both, you know, it looks good mirrored, I suppose. That's a good way to check anatomy, but it can also be kind of stressful if you do that a whole lot. So I would try to be discerning with how much you flip your picture, especially in an early sketch stage. So, I don't know, keep that in mind. There's a lot of different ways to practice, so find a way that suits you and keep with it. So I wasn't really sure what I wanted to call this section, so we're just gonna go with preparation. Anyway, now that the sketch is done, I throw down some rough colors on the layers beneath the sketch layer. Usually I start with the background first if I actually plan to not be lazy and do a background. So for the background here, I just put a gradient as a kind of placeholder because I knew I wanted the background to be some kind of sky scene, but I wasn't really sure on the specifics, so I just put down a basic gradient and some simple clouds for the time being. After that was done, I just started putting down the absolute base colors for Sakura, like her skin and her hair and her clothes and such, and then after all of those were down, I went into hue and saturation and tweaked them a little bit until they looked close to how I wanted them to look. And I hope you are understanding now that I really like using hue and saturation. It's really fun to see what kind of tweaks you can do. Anyway, from there I make some more layers for shading and little details like the red lines on her collar and her ribbon, I guess, in the front. For shading, I usually start with some kind of like purplish color, and then I go and do hue and saturation again and tweak it until I find the color that I think will look the best with everything. And then I tweak it some more by going and setting it on a bunch of different layer styles until I find one that looks the best with how everything else is looking. So really, a whole lot of this process is just me tweaking things until they look right with everything else. Hue and saturation is one of my favorite ways to mess with stuff, and then setting layers on different layer styles is also one of my favorite ways to mess with stuff. It's really fun. Try it out. Sometimes I'll set the sketch layer to color burn because that has interesting effects. Sometimes I'll set it to multiply. Sometimes I'll just leave it at normal. It just really depends on how things look. A lot of the times I'll put soft pinkish orangish lighting on the tops of heads and on the sides of eyes, and then set that layer to overlay or soft light or vivid light on really low opacity because that has interesting effects too. Usually I finish messing around with all the colors by adding an overlay layer on top of everything and filling it with some color and then messing around with that color in hue and saturation until I come across a color that kind of brings all of the other colors together cohesively. And then I'll go and set that overlay layer on a tolerable opacity because sometimes it can be really, really bright and overbearing. But I'll set it on something that's acceptable. And then after that, I'll merge all of the layers down into one layer. And then I go into the painting.
Voice.